Why is everyone looking at me? This isn't my fault. Dad.
You gotta get this fixed. We have guests coming in the next 2 hours.
All right, I know. I'll call the company.
Come on, guys. We gotta keep decorating. Very Christmassy. You letting the other boys play?
They're watching. It's fun, right?
No.
Ashton, your parents are looking for you.
Mom, can Ashton spend the night?
No. Honey, come on. It's Christmas Eve. He should be with his family. You know, Ashton, you should at least be with your family, like, once a year.
What can I say, Mrs. A? I'm a citizen of the world.
Yeah, well, you're certainly taking citizenship in this house. Hey, boys. It's gift time.
Successful, then we can charge the clients more and the firm makes more money.
Yeah, that makes sense. Kinda.
Excuse me. Hey, how are you?
Sure.
Thank you.
attention. Can we all go to the living room? It is time for presents. Thank everybody for coming to the Anderson family annual Christmas party. Caroline and I came from the exact same humble beginnings that you all have. In fact, back when we lived in Georgia, we didn't even have a penny to our name, just like Oliver. I'm sorry. I'm just trying to say that we have been there. But through a lot of hard work and determination, we were able to climb the ladder. Which we gained a perspective to understand how all of you are going through your struggles and remembered the struggles we once had. Anyway, we just wanted you guys to enjoy this Christmas party and get a little bit of hope to see how things can change for you like they did for Caroline and I.
And give you gifts. Many, many gifts, right? Okay, so without further ado, they all have stickers on them. Men, they are blue. Women, they are pink.
Girls are yellow. And boys have red.
All right, people, let's grab some presents. Take it easy, guys. You didn't honestly think we'd be rude enough to let you open up your gifts in front of everyone, did you?
Come on, we're going to open up our gifts tomorrow morning, as the Andersons have been doing for the last decade.
Should go over there. The bath bombs can be there, and the
shampoos can go over there.
And maybe you can open up another store soon, and you can have bubbles and 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 bubbles. I need bubbles all over the world. It's gonna be great, Mom.
Oh, I love you guys.
We love you too.
It's Valentine's Day, and you didn't make any plans?
Come on, Caroline, you know I've been killing myself at work. I'm sorry, I just totally forgot.
You forgot? Did you forget about this heart on the door? And did you forget this inflatable heart? And then did you forget about these hearts? You don't have a heart.
Caroline, I said I was sorry, and I meant it. Caroline! Come on, Caroline, let me in. I said I was sorry.
But how does he get to all the houses? Tom, it's your
time. Well, honey, he just borrows Santa's sleigh.
He must have spent a long time at our house. I had so much stuff, I couldn't even lift my Easter basket.
Now, to be honest with you guys, Easter Bunny...
Okay, we're
going to
get brunch. Brunch,
you guys,
brunch. What's wrong with you?
How dare you? Swear, you look adorable.
Oh,
I look stupid.
I mean, it does look kind of silly, right?
Yeah.
I swear,
no candy for you, Dad. It's not cool.
Don't get it. What did I say? Guys, wait up. guys, well, look, thanks for having us over. It's really appreciated.
I'm really sorry about the turkey and the cranberries and the stuffing. But it's totally fine. I don't know why I thought I could cook that myself.
As I tried to warn repeatedly. Look, I'm glad to hear everything's going so well at Bubble.
Yeah, sure it is. And I'm glad to hear that you guys are doing well at the office, right?
Yeah, they're going great. Yeah, things are slow, but it's getting better. Well, yeah, but they'll pick up. They always do, right? Let's hope. Look, yeah. See you at the party. Okay.
Bye, sweetheart. Bye. Thank you. See you guys soon.
Drive safe, guys.
Really?
What?
The turkey was okay. I was just saying that. Who's that?
I have no idea.
Happy Turkey Day!
I'm okay.
What are you doing here?
Oh, nice to see you too, my favorite nephew and his gorgeous wife.
Well, no, it's great to see you, but we just weren't expecting you. This is crazy.
Here I am. Yeah. Oh, I see that you have bags. Are you going somewhere?
Yes. I'm going to this lovely destination called your guest room. And I'm staying through Christmas and New Year's.
You are?
You are.
Uh-huh. And if things go well, I might stay longer.
Longer?
Uh-huh. Oh, look at this.
Are you still here?
Buddy, do you ever sleep at home?
Why would I sleep in a 1,500 square foot house, but I can sleep in a mansion?
Good point. And if your parents are cool with it, then so are we.
Did you have another kid? He came with the house.
Mom, Dad, Mr. Visitor.
Oh my gosh, look at you two. You're so beautiful and so big. Oh, I haven't seen you in 5 years. Look at you.
Well, my boyfriend and I broke up, and I wasn't feeling San Francisco, so I thought, why not go on my next adventure?
That's too bad, because I kind of like Tim.
No, it was Mike. Tim was 4 boyfriends ago.
We'll take these in the guest room.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's okay, right?
Oh,
What? Well, yeah, of course. Just go make yourself at home.
Thank you.
Okay, kids, I have presents for you.
What? Why'd I say that? And I had my own frog that I used to walk on a leash. Then when I left the commune, I moved in with this guy on Potrero Hill, and he was a pirate.
Like an on-the-ocean pirate?
No, an internet pirate. And he taught me how to hack into computers like, you know, at NASA or the Pentagon. Isn't that cool?
Yeah, that is really cool.
Super cool. But that didn't work out, and he got custody by Pentagon, so here I am to spend the holidays with my favorite family.
Aren't we your only family?
Yes. So it's a good thing you're my favorite.
You can come with us to the amusement park next weekend.
Oh, that's so sweet, but I have to work.
A job? I thought you just got here.
Yeah, well, I got a job on the way down here. I got a gig playing Mrs. Kringle on Rodeo Drive.
Really? That's so cool.
I know. I'm going to be Mrs. Kringle.
The last time she visited, she stayed until we moved and didn't leave a forwarding address.
Then get rid of her.
You get rid of her.
You're the one who said she could stay.
Are you two arguing?
Yes. No.
Because it's not good to fight in front of the children.
It's okay. We're used to it. They do it all the time.
What can I say? I'm committed to this firm. What are you doing here?
Oh, Hartman Global changed their minds. They don't want to settle. They want more.
What? They're getting $9 million. It's more than fair.
Yeah, well, they want the full 10.
$1 million is pocket change to these guys. This is a power play.
I'll let them power play their own grandmothers as long as we get to keep this account. We're going to court.
Ray, you should be happy about this. This means they're on the hook for another 6 months. Do you ever want more?
Yeah, that's why I'm thinking about raising our rates.
No, I mean, do you ever regret helping rich corporations sue other rich corporations?
No, not really.
I'll be ready for court.
That's what I'd like to hear. Keep up the good work, pal.
Yep. Jerk.
Tonight. Hate to eat and run, but enjoy.
Let's go play video games.
Is this a typical dinner at your house?
Yeah, it is.
How did this balance get so high?
Did you say something?
What? No. Hey, how are you?
Good. Yeah, you know, Brendan grew out of his hockey uniform again.
You gotta be kidding me. If that kid gets any taller, he's gonna grow out of this house.
I know. So I'm going to take him shopping this weekend. And Julia, she needs a check for her class trip. So can you just put some more money into the checking account?
Again?
What, is something wrong?
No.
Is everything okay?
Yeah, of course. So how was your day? How's Bubble?
Never better.
Oh, great.
Okay, honey, good night.
Good night, sweetie.
He's working on a big case.
Oh, hey, Dad.
Working hard?
Yeah, but I got time for you. What's up?
We need to go over some numbers for Hartman Global.
Ooh, we gotta put a hold on that. We gotta step up the Wayford situation. He's suing for defamation of character.
What? Well, the guy's a slumlord. He's lucky we got him off. He's the one who should be prosecuted.
Dad, you sound more like a DA than his defense attorney.
No, we're not doing it.
Why not?
We can't defend someone like that anymore.
Okay, what is going on around here? First, Ray doesn't want rich corporations as clients, and now you're picking and choosing who's worthy of defending? We're lawyers. It's our job to get our clients the money using the law the best we can.
It's also our job to be decent human beings.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means that throwing a Christmas party once a year for a tax write-off doesn't make you a saint. Michael, we moved here together. We built this firm from the ground up. Oh, we have a reputation in the community. We're better than this. We're better than helping the bad guys get away with stuff. You know that, right?
I don't even understand the question. Come again?
I want to be proud of this firm once again. Ever since we moved here, you've been leading the firm down a path of greed. It's making me feel dirty.
Yeah, well, it's also making you rich.
Doesn't matter.
Frankly, I don't even understand what's going on.
Oh, you don't. Well, how about Trevor Morgan? You got him off that hit and run on the technicality.
Yeah, he said he didn't see the six vehicles he hit, and I believe him.
Oh, how about Leslie Robinson? Suppose she didn't notice that she was stealing all the money from her employer. But you talked him into settling for nothing.
They couldn't prove anything.
She stole those people's pensions. I'm done defending the bottom of the barrel. A family name means integrity. Why? I have to take you onto the door. I'm firing you. Pack your things. Get out.
What? You can't fire me.
Not only can I fire you, I can send you to your room. You're out. You need to change your attitude, son.
You can't do this! It's Christmas!
Hey, honey. What's wrong? I can tell something's wrong. What is it? What? They can't fire you. It's your law firm, too.
Not anymore.
That makes no sense. How can they do that?
Caroline, they can do whatever they want. They own 51%, remember?
No. I just think I remember when you said on that trip to Bora Bora that it was 50-50. You promised me you sold that point, didn't you? Mm-hmm. Why would they do that?
My dad thinks I'm a bad image for the firm. He and the partners think that I'm greedy.
You've bought them all gold watches last Yep, okay. I guess I can see how that happened. Gosh, what are we gonna do?
I'm done fighting Caroline. I'm not fighting him anymore. I'm not fighting them anymore. I just want to do what's best for us. I want to be there for you and the kids, and that's it. That's all that matters to me right now. I don't know. Maybe I should take the year off. I can work with you here at Bubble. We still have Bubble.
No. I mean, don't do that.
All right, well, it doesn't matter. I'm going to figure something else out, and I promise it'll all work out. We'll be fine.
Well, you better. Honey, we have been living beyond our means for quite some time, and I have gotten accustomed to it, so...
Don't you think I know that?
Well, sometimes I wonder, Michael. Listen, this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna walk out that door. You're gonna march up to your father. And you are going to demand your job back.
Please, I'm begging you. Can I just have my job back?
I'm busy.
All right, listen. I apologize for my behavior. I've just been extremely stressed out lately. You know how the holidays can get.
You're stressed. You don't know what stress is, young man. Stress is working the tobacco fields until your hands bleed just so you can take care of your family. Stress is starting a law firm, not knowing if you'll be able to pay your employees. Stress is finally getting established and hiring your son, who gives you ulcers.
Dad, you're absolutely right. I don't know what you've been through. And I do know that you worked hard for your family.
You're not behaving like the son we raised you to be, and I'm done with it. We've already promoted Ray to partner.
What? You've already promoted Ray? Please, Dad, I'm practically broke. Christmas and the kids' birthdays just depleted me.
That's not my problem. I've made the decision, and your mother's in agreement.
Mom agrees with this.
Actually, it was her idea.
Come on, Dad. I can't afford to be unemployed right now. I'll do whatever it takes. I'll change, I promise.
Good one, son. Oh, yeah. You're not joking. Well, I am sorry. I can't help you. The decision's been made. It's what you kids call tough love. Now, I'm looking forward to seeing Brendan and Julia this weekend. Your mama can't make it. She's got bowling league. So, I got a lot of work to do. Can you please close the door after you leave? The defense never rests.
Myself in a jam and can use a job. Marty, come on, man. You owe me. Michael Anderson. We went to law school together. Yeah, I was just wondering if you had any job openings available. Yeah, how you been? You don't remember? Come on, man. Well, maybe I never liked you. It'd be much appreciated. You gotta be kidding me, right? You know what? I don't want to work with you anyway.
Whatever you got, that'd be great.
You know what? Just forget it. Thanks for nothing. Hello? No, absolutely not. I'm not gonna be your intern. Jerk! You know what? Forget I asked. Just forget it. Oh, hey, babe. No, my dad did not give me my job back. But hey, I did get a job from one of my old associates, so, yeah, we're gonna be good. I mean, I'm not really gonna be making quite the same money, but, you know, hours will be the same type of work stuff, so, you know, we're gonna be okay.
No wonder there's no customers. You know, I was thinking maybe we should put some of the bubble bath near the cash register.
It doesn't matter.
Why?
Look around. There's no customers. The store's a bust.
Well, I'm sure that'll pick up. You just need to do like a Facebook page with coupons, or you should just Instagram everything.
Maybe I'm just not cut out for retail.
Yes, you are. Don't say that. Your products are amazing. I use them all the time.
You do?
Yes.
Which ones?
This one.
That's tile cleaner.
Yeah. I use it on my feet. Really gets those rough spots. Hey, what about if you use the party this year to really promote your store?
Another thing. I think I'm going to cancel the party.
Why?
Because those parties are expensive, and this store's not making any money, so I'm a little worried.
You can't do that. People count on this party.
They count on the party for what?
Happiness, for holiday joy. Those people deserve to feel like they're welcome at a big Beverly Hills house at the holidays.
Wait, why?
Because there's nothing better than getting dressed up in your best clothes and forgetting all your worries. You provide that for these people.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Right?
Well, then, this party has to be the best it's ever been.
That's the spirit. Hey, wait, where are you going?
Well, to get this party started.
But what about the customers?
That's right. I forgot.
Wait for me.
I'm calling Anastasia.
Something to mimic an opulent Dr. Zhivago vibe. Ooh. And wouldn't it be fun to bring in a huge bear? It's right on the stairs, right here. A black bear simply screams, Russia!
I don't think they're Hey, I could dress like the top of a Christmas tree.
Oh, well, it's not really a costume party. The theme is just about the decor, my dear.
Is there any other theme that doesn't have the word, you know, opulent or luxurious? I'm just a little nervous about how much these decorations are going to cost.
Very funny, Kim. I always like your sense of humor.
But I know that it could be something that's, I don't know, maybe a little more Dickensian. You know, with a lot of decorations or food.
Like Scrooge?
Yes, that would be amazing. What about a Middle Eastern thing like Santa's harem? Big parachute pants? This is still a costume party.
So, we start right away. I bring Sasha, Lena, Sebastian, and Hugo. We get to work.
Wait, four? Assistants? I was really just thinking, no assistants.
What? No assistants?
You're really worried about expenses, aren't you?
Yeah, the accountant called and said that we're behind on our bills and that our savings have dropped significantly.
But I thought you and Michael had plenty of money.
Yeah, so did I, but the accountant is saying differently.
You have to talk to Michael about this.
I can't talk to him about anything. Haven't you noticed?
Yes, I have, but he's your husband. You have to have like a dialogue.
It's easier said than done. You know what, maybe I should just call this whole thing off and just do a smaller version of the party.
Just want to deposit on your credit card. We're already getting started.
Maybe not.
She's so Russian.
Anastasia, the party's not for another 3 weeks. What are you doing here?
Katie thought we should bring them in early. Small rental charge.
I was trying to. We need to get everyone in the festive, happy mood.
You hold that safe? I get right when I fire you. Where was I?
Something about a festive and happy mood.
Oh, yes, of course. Festive! Move them over there.
Is there a way that we could just postpone this part?
Postpone? I do not understand your English.
Only when I'm trying to save money.
I need painter's tape.
Painter's tape?
Just doing some touch-ups on the walls. They're being speckled.
Speckle.
Yes, darling, why are you repeating everything I'm saying? Are you ill?
Oh, I don't think so.
Stay away from me. Girls, come here. It's not good here.
I'm sorry she's so intense.
It's okay.
She's so Russian.
Hey, hon, what's up?
Can you pick up some painter's tape on your way home?
Painter's tape? Yeah, but why?
Spackling,
huh? Yeah, okay.
Where are you, by the way?
I'm actually on my way to court.
So late?
Yeah, babe, I'm pretty sure that's why they call it night court.
Okay, well, see you later.
Okay, I'll see you in a little while. Love you.
Bye. Love you, too.
Oh, man.
Yes, that's two extra large meat lover's pizzas.
Does Hugo need an entire pizza all to himself?
He's a big man, Hugo. Yes, and some pesto balls and chicken wings.
Is that entirely necessary?
This many, or I have to install two chandeliers. Not chicken rings, chicken wings.
Just stick with life, son.
Extra large deli platter.
Oh, no. A platter? Really?
Hey, Carolyn. Have a little status update.
This can't wait.
Everything's going great. That Anastasia sure knows how to handle a crisis.
What crisis?
Oh, nothing. It's just a medium-sized hiccup. Don't worry about it. Listen, I think we should talk because I'm a little bit concerned about...
Who could that be now?
Oh, you relax. I'll get it. It's probably just the construction crew.
Construction crew?
Yeah, I'm sure it's just minor stuff.
Say nothing, you hillbilly.
Nothing is minor right now.
And Caroline Anderson lawsuit. Intentional infliction of emotional distress? $1 million?
Maybe you should call her.
Are you just looking over my shoulder?
What difference does it make? It looks like Caroline could be in trouble.
Yeah, this woman is going to sue Caroline for infliction of emotional distress over a bubble bath. It's ridiculous.
Still, that is a lot to handle with everything else going on right now.
Wait, what is that supposed to mean?
That means I think you and Caroline should talk.
Yeah, well, this woman won't win. I will countersue and take her for everything she's got.
Don't be such a doofus. You think that's the right thing to do?
Oh, is it right of her to file a bogus lawsuit for infliction of emotional distress over a bubble bath?
No, but maybe she's just desperate. I bet there's a lot more to that story. I'm watching you. Okay, sure. How's your new job?
It's going. It's okay. You know, I'm learning a lot. Wait, how's Bubble?
It's great. Yeah, sales are happening.
Right?
Great. Bubble's going under.
What?
Well, yeah. Bubble needs to close. It's a disaster.
I thought you just said sales were good.
Well, no, I said that sales were happening, which they were. 4 times. This week. One lady thought I was a grocery store. You don't have a job?
No, I basically do not have a job. I kind of lied. I'm sorry, but I just didn't want you to worry.
Well, I guess I should be angry, but I kind of can't be because I wasn't exactly honest with you about the store. Michael, what are we going to do?
I have been doing everything I can, but nothing seems to be working. I just can't seem to find a job that'll pay enough to support us.
But anything's gonna help. Anything.
I've tried everything. I've tried calling every number on my phone.
Honey, what did you tell me?
Honestly, I wanted to tell you. I just didn't know how. I'm so sorry, babe.
No, I'm sorry. Nobody wants my products, and no, neither of us are making money.
You're being hard on yourself. It's not that nobody wants your products. It's just that nobody knows about them. Your products are amazing.
Really?
Yeah.
You think so?
Yeah, I know so. You know what? I was thinking maybe we should start a website for the store. Help reach out, right?
That's not a bad idea.
This is nice.
Nice?
Well, not the near bankruptcy part, but the you and I talking part. Us working things out together. I miss it. What happened to us?
I think that we have been married for a long time, and we got stuck in a rut.
Yeah, we definitely have been distant the past couple of years. I mean, I've been busy with work, and you've been extremely busy with the store and the kids.
Yeah, and somewhere along the line, we just lost us.
I miss us. I really do. Hey, you know what this reminds me of?
What?
Our very first Christmas together in Georgia.
Don't start.
Yeah, I was in law school then.
We were so broke.
Broke doesn't even describe. We didn't have money for presents or decorations. You know what? I don't even think we had furniture.
Oh, no, we did. We had that couch that we found on the side of the road, and then we hauled it up 4 flights of stairs.
That's right. We loved that couch.
But honey, that was a long time ago. We shouldn't be back where we started.
Babe, we're not back where we started.
Are you sure? Because we're broke again. And really, we just traded out your student loan for a mortgage and a private school tuition. And now you don't have a job, and my store's on the brink of closing. We are bleeding red ink.
Babe, it doesn't matter. Listen, we have each other. The kids. And we're still in love, right?
Yes. Yes, we are.
See? Money isn't everything. What matters the most is family.
But I don't even know how we fell into this trap. I mean, keeping up with the Joneses, always trying to one-up Ray and Patty, and always trying to impress everybody all the time. And it really didn't make us any happier, so what was this all for?
You know what's worse, though?
What?
That we both lost our southern accents.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. We haven't kissed in weeks.
Oh, really?
And you haven't kissed me like that in forever.
Well, there's plenty more where that came from, pretty much.
I love you, Michael.
I love you too, Caroline.
And you know what? You are an excellent lawyer. You're gonna find something.
Thank you. Oh, that reminds me. I have to tell you something. You know that customer of yours, Gertrude?
Yeah.
going to sue us for $1 million.
What?
Yep, she claims she suffered emotional distress when she found out your bubble bath was called a bath bomb.
Oh, well, now that's ridiculous.
Yeah, it is ridiculous. Looks like we might be getting a taste of our own medicine. I have an idea, though.
Well, yeah, you're going to sue her for triple her money, right?
No, I have a better idea. I think I came up with something that's going to work well.
But, Michael, we...
No, you said that I was a good attorney, right?
Yes.
Hey, Jeff. Thanks for calling me back. I appreciate it.
Sure thing, though. It's kind of weird to be investigating a case against Caroline, don't you think?
Yeah, I know. I owe you one, buddy.
Well, to me, it looks like this Gertrude lady is out for the money. She's a pretty serious debt, you know.
How bad? I didn't get a chance to go over that paperwork you sent me.
Some credit cards, but most of it's from Morgan Brothers Funeral Home. Her mom died. She can't pay the bills on unemployment.
She's a paralegal, right?
Yeah, for 14 years at Brockins Run, but they let her go about 2 months ago.
She must have had a bad year, but I'm not sure it's about the money this time. Hey, any chance you can send me your address?
Sure, I'll text you right now.
Appreciate it. Thanks, man.
You're
Anderson. Gertrude Thompson, right? I'm here in regards to the lawsuit you filed against Bubble and my wife, Caroline.
What are you doing here?
I was wondering if I could have a few moments of your time.
No. I will see you in court.
No, please. Gertrude, please, just give me a moment. That's all I ask. I brought lunch.
When you say that's just gonna convince me to open the door.
No, not at all. It's really more of a peace offering. I was hoping we could chat about the case and maybe eat like civilized people. It's Chinese, your favorite. I did my research. Listen, Gertrude, I know you lost your job, and it's just not fair.
You've been spying on me.
No, not at all. I called in a favor from my old law firm. The investigator there looked into it.
You're wanting to talk me out of suing, aren't you?
Sort of. But I looked into your case, and honestly, there's really no way you can win. And the more I looked into it, the more I saw your personal issues. And I want you to know that I'm here to help. I know about your mom, and I know you've taken care of her for quite a long time.
And she needed me.
Yeah, I bet. It must be difficult not having her around anymore.
I had her, and I had my job. And now I don't have either one. I mean, I have interviewed everywhere, and there is just nobody hiring.
Yeah, I know what you mean, believe me. But Gertrude, I'm serious when I say it. I want to help. I'm here to help.
Trust anybody, especially a lawyer. And why? Why would you want to help me?
Because that's what good people do, especially during Christmas time.
That would be nice. Thank you.
Hey, Dad.
I have someone I'd like you to meet.
Gertrude Thompson. Nice to meet you, sir. You can just call me Gertie.
Nice to meet you. What's this all about?
Well, your desk is really a mess.
It's always this mess about 10 a.m. She's to the point. I appreciate that.
Dad, listen, I know you're going to need a new paralegal when Joanne goes on maternity leave, and Gertrude here would be a perfect fit.
We are fully staffed, Michael, but with your gross negligence, we are on a hiring freeze. Why are you finding her a job when you should be looking for one yourself?
It's the right thing to do, and she can really use the work.
I never thought I'd hear you talking about doing the right thing in this office. Oh, you're good. When can you start?
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
forward, I already paid you for what you did.
I did not do half of the job, Miss Anderson. You either get it all or nothing. The Holy Ghost, too. It all goes away.
But you can't do that.
Yes, I can. Read your contract. Page 23, section 4C clearly states everything.
Please don't do this. The party's tonight. I have no choice. I am an artist. I do not paint F over painting. Let's just talk and maybe negotiate another price.
Negotiate?
What's going on?
Oh, don't worry, kids. It's just a little misunderstanding.
Why are they taking everything down?
Yeah.
Come on, I want you to help me with something.
Okay.
Come on, let's go.
Whoa, what happened to all the decorations?
It's a long story. Honey, we have to talk.
What is this, guys?
It's a Christmas tree.
Looks a little old, doesn't it?
It's vintage. Okay, we got it in the dumpster behind the Christmas tree lot. But that's where I get all my trees. I haven't bought one since 1995.
We know it's not a lot, but we can still have a tree.
I love it.
And so do I. Good work, guys.
Too bad Anastasia took all the ornaments with her.
Actually, I think I have a solution.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That was pretty funny.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. Wow. Yeah, and this is from the year that you guys were born.
That's right.
Yeah. Oh, and this was when you were in preschool. And you always got hungry, so you ate off the macaroni.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did, buddy. That's why we had to move it to the top of the tree.
Yes, it is.
You guys were so young.
Yes, we sure were. And then you two happened, and now look at us.
Exactly.
I can't believe we always had these things. Why don't we ever use them?
Well, honey, I think we just thought that a fancy Christmas was better.
I like these more than the ones Anastasia brings over.
Thank you so much for everything, by the way.
Oh, absolutely. I'm really happy that you're here this year. Just unfortunate that you can't experience an Anderson Christmas party.
Why not?
Well, I mean, look around. Pretty much canceled, right? We gotta start calling people and letting them know.
If we're canceling the party, then we're canceling Christmas for everyone.
He's right. People can't make new plans by tonight, so that's not fair.
How are we supposed to have this amazing Christmas party without Anastasia?
Yeah, we can't spend any more money. But Christmas? I mean, your Aunt Katie's never had any money, and I've never had a lame holiday in my life. Except for the time I went to jail. But those charges were dropped. I mean, like I would shoplift.
But if we all pitch in, we can do it. I'll do whatever it takes.
It's for the families.
We don't need any money.
You're right. We can just make our own decorations.
Okay, Christmas party's back on, everyone.
Let's get to work.
Yay!
Empty lot down the street. You know, there are free resources all around if you just know where to look.
Seems like your free resources are moving.
Are there rats in Beverly Hills?
Buddy.
Hey, honey. Where'd Ashton go?
To Jimmy's house. He got some gingerbread cookies.
Yeah, that makes sense. Oh, you gonna have enough for that?
Whoa!
Why is your father on the roof?
Oh, hey, guys! Don't worry, I'm okay. I got this.
I have no idea, but Mama's done with these.
Okay, well, I guess I'll cross that off the list. Where'd you learn how to make these?
Oh, my mother taught us.
Oh, she did?
Well, not exactly like this. See, she'd make Michael's mom and me these hair wreaths for the sweet potato festival. Oh, yes, I remember that festival. My mom used to take me to that. You know, those festivals are still an annual tradition in Osceola. They are? Seems like so long ago. I'm really happy that you're here.
I am too.
I'm grateful for you, you know.
You are?
Yeah. You have this unique ability to bring out the best in people.
Careful. You're gonna make me cry.
Stop it.
Okay, let's make these wreaths.
Okay.
Hey, what's with all the Valentine's Day decorations?
Well, they're red, aren't they? I'm just gonna repurpose them.
Brilliant. You know I'm proud of you, right?
Oh, I wish I felt that way. I'm just really disappointed that bubble didn't work out.
It's gonna be fine. You know why? Because you're both smart and creative, two big reasons I fell in love with you.
Yeah. I just wish that translated to the store.
Well, there's a lot of pressure owning your own company. Especially in the first year, right? But you'll figure it out.
That's why I fell in love with you.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Are you sure it has nothing to do with my superior ivy weaving skills?
No, honey. It's because you've always been so supportive of me.
Thank you, sweetie. It means a lot.
Hey, pass the tape. Toss the scissors, please.
No, don't toss the scissors.
Nobody needs the emergency room right now.
Guys, how many more of these do we have to make?
Excuse me, until we make enough to cover every window of your giant house.
Suddenly, I'm wishing we didn't have so many windows.
Oh, boy, I don't know how many more I can take. Pan crap. Oh, come on, suck it up, people. This is go time. Here, put these frozen peas on your hand. They help. Where did those come from? Don't ask questions you don't want to know the answer to. Oh, boy. Okay, just go get ready for your party. I got the food. What does that mean exactly? It means go get ready for your party. I got this.
That doesn't mean you're going to order like 100 pizzas.
No, it's going to be perfect. Trust me.
I trust you.
Okay. Bye-bye. Get pretty.
This looks fantastic.
It really does.
This one in charge, I knew would happen. She's so tough. Tonight's gonna be fun, guys! Yup!
Oh, yeah.
Well, I think it's gonna start a half hour early.
Hey, guys! It's Ray and Patty!
Hey!
Sorry we're a little late. Ray couldn't decide what to wear.
That's okay.
But we have something we'd like to show you outside.
Is everything okay?
Everything is fantastic. Come on!
All right,
go! I'm really sorry about what you had to do. No, it's okay. A good man got the job. Besides, I need some time away from the firm anyway.
Does that mean I get my watch back?
Heck no, I sold that thing a while ago. But look at this. Got myself a nice $10 digital.
Nice.
Where's the food? Don't worry, I had a plan.
But people are going to be here in a couple of minutes, and we need to feed them.
Caroline, I swear on a stack of cookbooks, it's going to be here. Yeah, go. Have a drink. Or two. That's what I'm going to do. Now, where is the wine? They don't have any. Bunch of hillbillies.
Trusted you.
Yes. I used to be a birthday party princess, so I have a knack for this.
Oh, forceful.
See, I told you. Christmas potluck.
Katie, look at this one. Where would you like me to put this amazingness?
Put that in my mouth. No, put it over there.
Okay.
Oh, my God. It's like, this chocolate is like talking to me. It's saying, eat me.
And you're passing out.
Bye.
I don't want to hear it. You guys can stay up late, drink all the hot chocolate you want.
Damn.
Our children really are adorable, huh? Thanks for the cookies.
Position as his legal assistant.
Oh, he did?
He did. But more importantly, I owe you an apology. Filing that lawsuit was not right. I got scared. I was unemployed. I thought I needed money. But then I realized that money doesn't solve all your problems, right?
Is that we truly understand what is important to us in life.
Hey, don't be so serious. It's a party. Hi, I'm Aunt Katie.
Hi, I'm... Well, just call me Gertie.
Okay, Gertie, I'll call you that. Christmas party. If you'd like, you could decorate a cookie in this room. You can cut your own snowflake in the den, or you can make a Christmas card for an at-risk family in the guest room. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you.
So, the decorations look incredible.
Thank you. I never would have thought of this as a theme, but I think it's perfect.
Yeah, I do too.
Yeah, this is your best one yet. Sharon, how you doing?
The first step is to grab a handful of M&Ms.
Too pretty to eat.
The trick is all in how you spread the icing. You want to make sure the entire surface of the cookie is covered. Then you have space for whipping.
So it's scientific.
Yes.
Honey, did you know that your father was a pastry chef?
No, I had no idea. And he probably should have stuck with it because I've never seen him this happy.
Actually, everybody looks really happy. And it's all because they're just getting involved with making something.
Or another one of your inspired ideas.
Hmm.
What is it?
Well, I think that's what I should do at the store.
What do you mean?
I think I got caught up with thinking that people wanted something expensive or exclusive when really all they want to do is put their hands on something. Well, we should have a make-your-own soap counter at Lovell. People could pick their scent, like lavender and lime verbena. Or they could put, like, soap additions, oatmeal, crushed almonds, and then they could come in groups and parties.
Absolutely love it.
Yeah, I should call the supplier tomorrow.
Yes.
Hey, you guys, look what you're standing under.
Oh, boy.
Michael, you haven't kissed me under the mistletoe since, well, before the kids were born.
Well, then, I guess I owe you a kiss. Oh, hey, listen, Also, my wife's sister's in town, so I bought her.
Nice. Yeah, I can always count on you, Ray, for a couple plus ones, right?
Well, look, one of her friends happens to be pretty high up in the DA's office, and I thought you should meet him.
Yeah, of course, and I'm absolutely free right after Christmas.
Well, I was thinking more like right now, since he's right up there.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
absolutely. Let's do this.
Let's do it.
Giving yourself to others. Brendan, Julia, will you please explain?
Everybody takes a stick out of the bowl, and whatever your stick says, that's your Christmas present. And if you get your own, you have to grab a different one.
There you go.
Okay, kids, go ahead.
Talking about the bacon to anyone at the office.
Free lawn mowing for a month. Thank you, Brendan.
I got free carpool services for my kids.
I got free guitar lessons.
Oh, good.
A hot stone massage. That sounds painful.
Oh, I almost forgot. Gorgeous wife, I have one specially for you. Until after the party, but Ray brought somebody to see me.
Oh, yeah, Patty told me somebody from the district attorney's office.
Yeah, but not just somebody, the district attorney.
You're kidding.
No, I'm not. Apparently they lost a couple ADAs and they want me.
Oh, honey, no, that's amazing.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't start till the second and I wouldn't be making as much money,
no,
but...
it's fine. We're gonna make this work.
Yes, we are.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, man. Just about parties and presents. What matters most, and we all know this, is family and friends. And if we have that, we don't need anything else. So thanks again, you guys. Happy holidays, and who's ready for some snow?
Thank you.
Trip romance.